Today, I'm going to be showing you guys some cool ways to manipulate your UV islands here in Blender. So we know already a little bit about it if you watched my video on UV islands. For example, if I left click to deselect everything and press L over one of these islands, you can see I can select them, and if I want to move them, I just press G to grab, or I can press S to scale, and I can press R to rotate. So that is the basics of manipulating islands. But if I come down here, you can see I've got a few more tools. These ones here are just pretty much the same as what we've been using with hotkeys. So if I press this, this will allow me to move it like this using the arrows. So if you're more comfortable with that, that's something you can use. You've also got one for rotate and one for scale as well, and one for all kinds of transforms. Here I've got an annotate thing. This hasn't got anything to do with editing your UVs, but it's cool if you want to add some notes. For example, I could write this. There you go, now you know this is a UV. Then we've got this option called Rip Region, which essentially allows us to, when we select a vertex, for example, I'm just in vertex select mode, which is up here. Usually, if I come back to my select box option, which is the default, and press G, you can see it'll, when I move things, it's all connected like this. But this Rip Region, left click and drag to move it, you can see it's going to move it apart. Make sure not to press G here, because that'll just access the grab command. I'll press Ctrl Z to undo that. If you don't want to rip region by selecting it, you can also press V, and that's going to also rip it apart like this. Then we've got this grab option, which is a little bit different from just pressing G. It's more like a brush, a bit like in sculpt mode, and I can just left click and drag, and this will allow me to move my UVs around. This looks pretty horrible, so I'll just press Ctrl Z to undo that. For some UVs, this will be a really handy tool. We've also got the relax option, which can be good if you've got some UVs which are maybe a little bit more squished together. You can see here though, it doesn't really have much of a use case. And we also have a pinch option. This will allow us to pinch some UVs together. So I could use it here, and you can see it's going to start pinching our UVs together here. If you want to change your size of your radius, you can just press F, just like with a brush, and that's going to increase the size, and you can see pinch things much easier that way. And also, for this thing at the top select box, all this does is it allows you, when you left click and hold, to select multiple things like this. But you're probably already aware of that. You can also left click and hold this though, and you can see there's a few other options. Tweak, for example, allows you to just left click and drag to move things like this. Then you've also got select circle, which is really cool. It's more like a brush. And then you can just left click and it's just going to keep on selecting things here like this. We've also got select lasso, which is a bit like the select box, but it's more flexible. See, I can go all the way around like this. It's going to select everything that was in that lasso. And yeah, that just about covers it. I thought I'd go over some of these tools on the toolbar here. You can see there's this option called cursor, and that's to control the 2D cursor. I'm going to talk a little bit more about that in a separate video. If you want to learn more about UV unwrapping, make sure to check out my free playlist, which goes through plenty of tutorials starting from a beginner level to introduce you to the concepts of UV unwrapping and some handy tips like these ones here. Thank you so much again for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.